The opposition leader and former education minister, Andrew Holness, says it's time to re-examine the curriculum used in schools across Jamaica. Mr. Holness explained why at a function in Sedan yesterday.
The opposition leader was making the rounds through schools on Teachers' Day when he made a stop at Fern Court High in St. Anne. Just a week after the budget debate ended in Gordon House, Andrew Holness was making this argument.
The growth of the economy in a sustainable way will not come from the large projects. The building of a new highway, the creation of the logistics hub, the expansion of the port, those things will help. But we have seen these large projects before. Mass investment in tourism, massive expansion in telecommunications, building highways, and it has not resulted in sustainable growth.
It's the same argument that the opposition spokesman on finance, Audley Shaw, made during the budget debate, only to hear it rejected by the finance minister, Dr. Peter Phillips, who says there is no over-reliance on mega-projects. But Mr. Holness was making a slightly different point to students. He feels education is one of the keys to growth, but is not convinced Jamaica's education system is teaching students how to be engines of growth.
We have to reform and transform education in such a way that it supports the development of our economy. We must take a second look at our school curriculum. I know that the Heart Trust has conducted a manpower survey, but I want to go further than the Heart Trust. I think the Ministry of Education needs to look carefully at its curriculum and see whether or not the curriculum supports and enhances the development of the economy. We must make our education system demand-driven. We must make our education system responsive to our economy.
It's part of the reason he wants the money the government now collects from the education tax to be used exclusively for education, which does not happen now.
The incremental increase in the education tax, I recommend it strongly to the government that they should put it in building more schools for our Jamaican students. The conditions under which you have to learn are not always helpful to enhancing effective learning. We need more schools, more classrooms, better facilities for our students.
Archibald Gordon, TVJ News.